Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Logic Medico. Today's interesting topic is levator veli palatini. It is one of the muscle of the soft palate. So let's see this muscle, levator veli palatini. Before going to that, if you are new to my channel, kindly subscribe to my channel and press the bell button to get the latest notification of the videos. So levator veli palatini, it's a muscle of soft palate. This is the muscle, levator veli palatini. So what is this soft palate? In the roof of the oral cavity, there is one bony structure. It's called the hard palate. It is covered by mucous membrane, the red color carpet. Just posterior to that, there is one fibromuscular curtain which is hanging freely at the junction between nasopharynx and oropharynx. It's called as a soft palate. This soft palate has got a conical projection in the midline, which is called as a uvula. Okay, levator veli palatini is one of the muscle of the soft palate. As the name suggests, it will elevate the soft palate. It begins from eustachian tube level. It is going to the soft palate, and it is a muscle of soft palate. So in this soft palate, there is one foundation, that is a connective tissue membrane called palatine aponeurosis. Then all the muscles are going towards that. Then ultimately it's covered by mucous membrane, which is the red color carpet. The anterior surface of this soft palate has got stratified squamous epithelium because it is facing the oral cavity. It's a wear and tear epithelium. The posterior surface of this soft palate will be covered by respiratory epithelium, which is pseudo stratified ciliated columnar epithelium with goblet cells. So coming to the levator veli palatini muscle, this is the muscle. Okay. This is the eustachian tube. Okay, come up to the origin of this muscle. It arises from the under surface of the apex of the petrous part of temporal bone and from the medial lamina of the cartilage of the auditory tube or eustachian tube. All that you have to remember is here one bone will be the petrous part of temporal bone. Obviously, this is the lower surface of that, and also from the medial side of eustachian tube. It descends vertically downwards, medial to the medial pterygoid plate, and then gets attached to the upper surface of palatine aponeurosis, that is an insertion. So when it is inserted to this upper surface of palatine aponeurosis, when this muscle contracts, when it shortens, what will happen to the soft palate option? Will it get elevated or will it get depressed? If you are told elevated, then it's a correct answer, because levator veli, levator is a Latin word, elevation is English. Okay, so the action is elevation of soft palate. So when the soft palate gets elevated, the nasopharynx above is separated from the oropharynx below. So the food from the oral cavity or the oropharynx cannot enter the nasopharynx. That is a function of levator veli palatini. So all these muscles of the soft palate are supplied by one nerve. It is the 11th cranial nerve, accessory nerve. Okay. Except tensor veli palatini, except this muscle, tensor veli palatini is supplied by mandibular division of the trigeminal nerve, whereas all the remaining muscles including this levator veli palatini is supplied by accessory nerve or 11th cranial nerve, whereas the muscle of the tongue is supplied by 12th cranial nerve. Easier way to remember, soft palate is above, right? So 11, tongue is below, right? So next number is 12. Okay, so the nerve supply of levator veli palatini is 11th cranial nerve or the accessory nerve. Okay, in summary, levator veli palatini is a muscle of soft palate. It causes elevation, therefore the name levator. It begins from the eustachian tube. Upon contraction, it elevates the soft palate and also dilates the eustachian tube, therefore the name veli. So levator veli palatini is one of the muscle of soft palate. It elevates the soft palate, cuts off the connection between the nasopharynx and the oropharynx. Now supply, I just now told you, it is a 11th cranial nerve or the accessory nerve. It supplies the levator veli palatini. Then this muscle is important to prevent the velopharyngeal incompetence, that is, soft palate is unable to cut off the connection between nasopharynx and oropharynx, either because the soft palate is short or due to some pharyngeal surgeries. So this muscle is important to prevent the food, not only the food from going upwards, but also some of the sound, speech sounds, which can go into the nasal cavity and cause hyper resonating voice, which happens in velopharyngeal incompetence. that is a clinical significance of this muscle, levator valley palatine. I hope you like this video. Kindly share this video with your family and friends, and don't forget to press the thumbs up button. Subscribe to my channel if you are not yet done, and press the bell button to get the latest notification of videos. Thank you once again for watching this video.